Good day, my dear friends. Welcome back with a new interesting case. Today, our appointment is the case number 40. Case number 40 is representing a 5-year-old boy presented with low back pain and weakness of the lower limbs associated with slight muscular atrophy and urinary retention or urinary incontinence. This is the first series, and this is the second one. I give you 10 seconds. After that, I will explain the series and type of exam and discussion explanation next slide. This is an MRI study, and the MRI have sequences. This is T1 sequence and this is T2 sequence, as a disc water in the disc appearing bright in the T2, however appearing dark in the T1. So this is T1 in this view, which is sagittal MRI view, and this is T2 sagittal MRI view. What is the abnormality in this boy, 5 years old and complaining from urinary incontinence? If you look at the spinal cord they have abnormal position, and there are thickened here of the phylum terminal also. There are widening of the spinal canal, and there are suspected defect in the posterior element of the bony component of the lower lumbar vertebra. Let us shifting to the next slide. So, discussion and explanations. The keywords about this case: sagittal T2 weighted MRI imaging showing the cord in abnormal position. So, there are an elongation, thinning of the spinal cord with thick of the phylum terminal, as I explained in the previous slides. The low lying also of the spinal cord, it appearing as the level of the L2 inferior vertebral end plates, and this is not normal because the normal position is at the level of D12 L1. So there are low lying of the spinal cord, and if you look, this is the canal, this is the ventral aspect, and this is the dorsal aspect. The conus, which is the terminal part of the spinal cord, distal part of the spinal cord, it appeared dorsally positioned also in contact to the dural sac, as we see here in this image. There are widening of the dural sac. Look at that widening compared with the proximal part of the dural sac, which appeared normal. However, there are widening here of the dural sac, which meaning there are defect, pulling defect here, resulting in this widening. In axial image also, confirming this widening of the dural sac, and also there are incomplete posterior fusion of the vertebral body, which representing dysraphism. This is the keywords and the finding to diagnose this congenital anomalies of the spinal cord in this boy. You should also complete analysis of the spinal abnormalities and associated alterations such as lipomas and meningocele, which can be seen at that regions. Lipomas, meningocele can be diagnosed by T2 as a sac or T2 high signal in the posterior element, bulging outside the boundaries of the dural sac. However, lipoma better to seen in the T1 weighted image is a lipoma appearing a high signal as it contains fat and appeared as a lesions with high signal in the T1 also outside the dural sac. In these situations or this specific case, there are no lipoma or meningocele, but should be excluded also because the T3 cord are associated with other abnormalities in the bones and the collections like lipoma and meningocele. Also, you should exclude screening the body of the that boy to exclude Vectoral syndrome, and the vectorals representing every letters representing a system like V, which representing a vertebra. You should exclude fusion vertebra, dysraphism of the vertebra, and the abnormalities of the vertebra, butterfly or like this. A representing A, anus, as anal atresia or any anal abnormalities as a congenital disease, C, cardiovascular tree, and the cardiovascular tree like dextrocardia, which is the most common or famous findings in Vectorer syndrome. When you examine this boy, for example, you should ask for the chest x-rays to exclude this dextrocardia, and TE from tracheoesophageal fistula also, which also associated with Vectorer syndromes and associated with this vertebral dysraphism. R should be excluded by ultrasound for these boys to exclude any renal abnormalities or renal congenital disease like agenesis or ectopic kidney, duplication kidneys, and all these should be excluded or confirmed because Vectorer the syndromes can see another anomalies in this system. And the last letter, the L from limb abnormality also should be excluded. So the final diagnosis for that specific case of the sagittal T1 weighted image, T2 weighted imaging, and this is sagittal T1 weighted image, is the CSF appearing dark, axial T2 and axial T1 for that boy showing abnormal location of the cord with thickened phylum terminals, and this abnormality is called T3rd cord. T3rd cord is part from the spinal dysraphism. It can be associated with other anomalies, or it can be diagnosed alone, like in this case. So the final diagnosis in this case is T3rd cord. I hope these lessons have helped to make something new for you, and also you can follow me in the Facebook group or my YouTube channel for more than 100 presentations. You can watch it. Also, every Wednesday is another case review, and every Sunday another part anatomy for FRCR1 part 1. Thank you very much for your watching, and have a nice day.